A baby dedication is basically the believing parent saying that this is our child, and we want to dedicate our child to the Lord. And there's no set way of doing this. Some churches may have one. I've done a couple of these, but I've never had a set way, so I'm just going to simply ask basically like I would if I was baptizing him. So, Thomas, and don't say it, Micah. Do you profess faith in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior?
Yes.
All right. Are you willing to dedicate your child to the Lord Jesus Christ?
Yes.
All right. And what that means is more for the sake of the relationship from you to them, to the child, than it is upwards, because obviously the child can't make any decision at this point. You are saying we want to dedicate our child to the Lord and that we will be responsible Christian parents towards this child. And so what I would recommend, this is just a part of what I would say to a parent, that you would start today if you don't do it, and read the Bible to your child as if it was an adult. I would do that today, and I would do that every day of the life of your child, is start by getting the Word of God in there. And by doing that, you will be instilling in this child something that is foreign to this child, all right? Everything that comes externally is foreign to us, and it's either going to be positive or it's going to be negative. And so you want to do everything possible to have a positive influence on your child, and you will get no more of a positive influence than being godly parents between each other and godly parents toward this child, and that starts with the Word of God. Okay, I could take you back to the book of Deuteronomy, and I'll just misquote it for you instead of taking you there. Is you are to talk to the child as you come in and as you go out about the Lord, as you sit down and as you rise up, and when you walk along the byways and the pathways, talk to the child about the Lord. The more that you do that, the more into the Word of God this child will be, and the Word of God is what leads us to Jesus. It's the only way to understand Jesus in his fullness. So we'll say a prayer over the child. Heavenly Father, these parents have asked to dedicate this beautiful child, Solomon, to you. And they have asked that this child would be set apart to you. And already that is the case because they are believing parents in Jesus Christ, your son. And so, Lord, we would just ask that you would honor their commitment and that you would prod them when they are not feeling up to reading the Bible to their child or speaking about it, that you would prod them and remind them this is an obligation that they have made and that they have committed to, and that this child would be set apart to you all the days of their life because of their actions towards this child. And yes, Lord, we do ask that you bless this child as well. We ask that you bless the child with health and long life and every good thing that can come upon it. But should you withhold your hand from that, and for any reason it has sickness or trials or difficulties, that this child would still understand that there is a better hope which is found in Jesus. And this life is temporary, it is fleeting, and that hope will be realized as sure as the ground is under our feet, that this child will stand in the presence of Jesus Christ because it is raised as a child of God and it will someday make its own commitment to Jesus Christ. We pray this now and for all the days of Solomon's life, that he would be a faithful servant of God, not departing like the first Solomon did, the one in the Bible who went many different directions and finally had to wait until the end of his life to realize what he was told from his youth, is that you are the better way. Help this child never to have to be in that situation, but to always persevere. We pray this, Lord, that you will be glorified, that this child will be edified and built up in you, and that the parents will be pleased as parents in the child that they have, and that they will be honored by you when they stand before you in their presence. We pray this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I think I said their presence, your presence. Anyway, there you go. Thank you very much. Let me hold the little child so people can prove that I have picked up the child. I have done this many times. My children were young, but look, it's even smiling at me finally. First thing it did, I'm sorry. I see this hair like my daughter, and it just is like, okay, anyway, yes, the first thing this child did when it was brought into the church today was look at me and start crying. Yes. What a beautiful baby. All right, there we go. Okay, here we go. I'll give this precious treasure back to you. All right. All right, God bless both of you. All right.
Congratulations.